to attach a file from a form to an email using Power Automate. In this video, I'll show you how to take a file uploaded to a Microsoft form and attach it to an email using Power Automate. First, create your form in Microsoft Forms. Initially, the form will be under your name as the owner. To move the form to a team, select the More option dots and choose Move to a Group. Then select the team you want from the list. This example form has two questions, an upload file question and a long text response question. Ensure the form is set to allow file uploads. Note that the file upload question type can only be used if the settings are set to People in Department for Education can respond. This option isn't available if Anyone can respond is selected. Go to the EdPass portal and open Power Automate. Select Create and choose Automated Cloud Flow. Name your flow and set the trigger to When a new response is submitted, Microsoft Forms. Select Create. Select the first action. Fill in the form ID by selecting Enter Custom Value and copying the form ID from the web address of your form. Add a new action to get response details. If you don't see an action you need in the menu, type it into the search. Use the same form ID and select the lightning icon to set the response ID to response ID from the dynamic content window. If you haven't asked for the user's name, use their email address to get their details. Add a new action to add the user profile V2 and set the user to the responder's email, again selecting from the lightning menu. Select Save to save your flow. Then preview and complete the form to test the flow. You need to have at least one form response before you can add the next two actions to your flow. Ensure the test runs successfully by checking the save flow in Power Automate. In Teams, navigate to the team where the form is located. It'll be located in Shared Documents in a folder called Apps, Microsoft Forms, and then a folder with the form name and a folder with the question name. Select Open in SharePoint. Back in Power Automate, add a new step to pass JSON. This will get the information from Microsoft Forms and turn it into text that we can use in our email. For content, select the lightning icon and the file upload question from the response details. Copy and paste the schema provided in the video description below into the schema box to get the correct JSON schema. Add a new action to get file content using the path SharePoint. In the site address box, paste in the URL of your Microsoft team. Copy everything to the left of Shared. Use the picker to navigate to the file in SharePoint. This will hard code the file path. Make the file path dynamic by removing the file name and using the name field from the path's JSON. Check that the address is correct. Within the apply to each action, add an action to send an email v2. Provide the recipient's address. It can be any email address, it doesn't have to be an @schools email. Subject and body. You can use dynamic content for both the subject and the body of the email if you wish. Under attachments, set the name to name under parsJSON from the dynamic content and the content to file content from the dynamic content box. Test the flow by selecting the previous submission and ensuring everything runs successfully. Check your email to confirm that you've received the email with the form attachment.